Okay, so this is the last part of today. This is just kind of an extension, but we're going to look at how average value actually relates to the mean value theorem. So the average value of the function, average value of this f of x function, okay, is the area underneath this curve made into a rectangle divided by the width, which gives you this height here, that blue line there. And we can say that the average value must happen in the interval between 0 or between a and b. Okay, that's a statement I'm going to say. I'm going to say the average value must happen at some point c, where c is in between a and b. Okay, c exists somewhere there. We don't know exactly know where it is. We're not going to actually try to find it either, but we're just going to say it exists. Well, this really is just another form of the mean value theorem, okay? Because if I want to find the mean value, this is actually it's almost like the reverse of the mean value theorem. This is really just another form. Because if I take a look at this, if I say the derivative, the mean value theorem said this, the derivative at c is equal to the average slope between b and a. Okay, so well, if that's the case, then if I just change this into, this is my mean value theorem, this is MVT. Really, I can just change this slightly and say this: the derivative of big F is equal to big F of b minus big F of a over b minus a. Well, I'm going to be able to generate that very easily here, okay? Because I can say that f prime, let's say that this is going to be big F. This is the average value, so big F of c, I'm going to write like this, f of c is equal to big F of b minus big F of a all over b minus a. So notice that this average value, being able to find, know that the average value must exist as an f of c coordinate between a and b. This is really just actually just another form of the mean value theorem. If we actually work this out, yeah, I to find the difference in those two points divided by the run of that graph. And essentially, we're saying that that's the same. Okay, so we're saying that the f prime, and I can change that. Remember that f represents the derivative of big F. There it is. There's my mean value theorem showing up exactly the same as this form of the equation, this statement here of average value forming showing up somewhere between those two points.